right, hello and welcome to another Expert Insight interview. My name is John Golden from Sales Pop, online sales magazine, and Pipeliner CRM, joining you from San Diego. And today I'm delighted to be joined by Terry Igioma, who is in Dallas, Texas. How are you doing?
I'm great. Thanks so much for having me, John. I'm so excited.
Yeah, and Terry is from Invest with Terry, where she helps people understand how to invest properly and make income. And she has a goal, and this is amazing, she has a goal of having 1,000 of her students make $1,000 a day, right?
Yes, it's the $1 million a day campaign.
$1 million a day.
1,000 people make $1,000 a day, we would be generating $1 million a day. And then we just imagine, like, what could we do to solve problems of the world and change people's lives with that kind of money?
Absolutely. And so as we were just discussing just quickly before we came on air, is that obviously through this whole crisis and the upheavals in society, all of that, I mean, I think people are taking a hard look at, okay, where's my life at right now? Where's my income at? Is my job safe? You know, what does the future hold? What would I like if I had additional money? What would I like to do with it? Maybe I'd like to do something to make a positive impact on society, as you mentioned. So what is your advice to people who maybe for the first time or for the first time in a long time are thinking, you know, I need to actually play a more active role in how I generate income, especially investment income, as opposed to just sticking it in a 401k and hoping that everything is fine by the time I retire?
You know, John, one of the many myths that many people had about investing is that you would only do it for the long haul. It was a buy and hold type of thing. Mm-hmm. But I think now over 12 million, I heard a statistic recently that over 12 million retail investors were jumping into Robinhood. So I think now many people are thinking, wait, there's a way to actively generate income to actually pay for my bills or pay for my short-term goals. For me, when I first started, I just wanted to pay for travel. I was like, my trip to Greece is $3,500. I need to make, if I could just make a few dollars a day, I can save up for that trip. And I learned that I could do that with investing. I actually even thought about, I could actually replace my income by just making $300 a day. And many people don't think about it like that, those small bite-sized goals. And it's really actually, I think it's simple, but there are ways to invest in a stock, buy it low, sell it a little higher, but do that in an active way so that you can actually generate income to pay for your goals.
Yeah. And I mean, that sounds fantastic, but maybe a lot of people are saying, okay, yeah, that sounds good, but I know nothing about this. And it sounds like it would be very time consuming and, you know, picking the right stuff. How do I know I pick the right one? Maybe because you're an expert, you could do it, but then me, I just lose all my money or it'll suck up too much of my time.
Yes. And I actually, so I have a trade and travel course, and many of my students felt that way when they first started. But like, I think of one of my students was an RN nurse and she worked all the time. And her big thing was, Terry, I just need to get some of my time back so I could take my kid to school. That was the one thing she was working towards. If she could make a little bit of extra income, she wouldn't have to work overtime. She could lower her hours. And so it's definitely possible. One of the ways that we help people lower time is, instead of doing a lot of research, we're technical analysis traders. So I teach them how to read a chart, and that takes away some of their hours. Another thing in terms of, you know, some people think, well, Terry, it's too hard. I don't know how to pick good companies. Well, I give them my watch list, and I've been trading for 10 years. So I teach them how to pick good companies, but also give them a little head start. So I think it's really about finding other traders that have been successful, and then you can start working with them to build your own trading strategy.
And then what do you say to people who say, okay, this sounds great, but you know, I don't have any really spare capital to get started?
So I will say investing does take a little bit to start. I can't tell you that you're going to make a ton of money with zero money. But there are ways to start at baby steps. So I use a program called TradeStation. You can open an account with just $500. Right. And with that $500, you can then actually practice in a simulated account. And while you're learning, practice there with fake money until you get good. I think that's the best way to get started. You start with something small, practice until you're good, and then you can start building your account and start practicing with your real money. So that's where I would say to start. So it doesn't take a ton to get started.
Yeah. And like you said, maybe what you just need to do is look at all the money you're spending today and say, okay, if I stop spending a little bit on that and just put that aside to give myself some trading money, then I can experiment and see how I do.
Yeah. So like we talked a little bit about coronavirus, but just imagine like all the ways that you're saving money right now. Like you don't have, well, for many people, we didn't have to drive to work. So you saved money on gas. For those that are getting unemployment, well, we were getting an extra $600 a week. Well, what would you like? Can you imagine if you were able to make that $600 a week actually into more money every week? Like that's a huge thing. So there's been a lot of savings during this time because we were at home. And then there's been some other ways that we've gotten additional capital. And now it's just about making that money work for you.
So what are some of the steps you know, that you teach people about? Okay, you know, you pick companies and that, and then, but how do you help people get better and more comfortable, and so that they can, you know, they can do this over a period of time and they can protect their portfolio and they can know when to switch and what to do?
Sure. So these are the things I think that everyone investor needs to look for. So everybody get your pen. This is what I'm telling you all the secrets right now. So first, it is really important to pick good companies. And I suggest picking companies that are healthy companies, best in breed. And over time, so like if you look over a year, and you can do this real easy, like look at a CNBC app or Yahoo Finance, just look at over a year, have they been on an uptrend? And it might be a little spotty because during coronavirus, we had a big dip like in March. But if you look over time, I want you to pick the best companies. That's going to be different than some people think, well, I have a little bit of money, I should pick a penny stock. No, I want you to still go with the healthy companies. And if you're struggling, think through what companies are hiring right now. A lot of times the healthiest companies are still hiring people. So think like that. That's an easy way to kind of think about it too. So first, we're going to think about picking good companies. Then the next thing that's important in trading is you have to figure out how to protect yourself from losing. And there's several ways to do this. So like I teach a really robust risk management plan. But one of the simple ways is there's actually like orders that you can put in, one of them called a stop loss. And it'll, if the stock is coming down, it'll actually get you out of the market. That's a huge thing to know about because at least you have a fail safe. Hey, if everything starts going down, I know I'll be protected, right? And there's other ways too, like you can look at making sure not to get in at the highs, wait for stocks to come down a little bit. Also your quantity size. So these are things we think about in like protecting ourselves from losing. Then the next big piece is you have to start learning to read charts. And I read candlestick charts, but it's a lot easier than it sounds. I know when you're looking at the chart, it's gonna have like the red and green and it looks crazy. But like there are ways to look at those formations and find, well, the third thing that's really important is learning how to read charts. And it's going to look a little crazy. It's going to look like there's a lot of red and green all over the place. But you can actually look at formations in those candlesticks to figure out where big banks like Goldman Sachs and Morgan Stanley, where they're buying and selling. And if you have a lot of buy orders, so like say they put in an order, I want to buy 1 million shares of Amazon at 2000. You can see that on a chart and you can actually go with them. I think many people get scared that they're going to be fighting against the big banks and, oh, well, I'm just a small fish and I can't time the market. That's true, but you can go with the bigger money. And so like we can look at a chart to figure out where you buy and where to sell so that you can actually make gains. And then the final piece is just, it's always important to have a trading plan. I think where a lot of investors mess up is they don't have consistent steps that they follow. They're kind of going by their gut. Oh, I feel like this stock is going to do like this. Yeah. No, that's not, that's not how you make money. You need, like, I have a 7-step trading plan that I follow every time I take a trade. That gives me consistency and it takes out the emotions. So now I'm not trading based on emotions. I know, hey, if it falls in this criteria, then I'll take the trade. So those are some things I think are important for every investor.
Yeah. No, that's great. But as you alluded to earlier, sometimes the mistake people make, especially when they don't have a lot of money, is they think, okay, well, look, I could get a lot of shares of a penny stock. But if I go after one of the bigger companies, whatever, maybe I can only buy 2 shares or whatever it is. And that's obviously a big mistake.
It is. And I actually did the numbers with my students recently. Like we had a coaching call and we looked at if I were to invest in, we were doing options, but we were looking at like the S&P, which was really expensive. And you can't really invest in the S&P, but we were just looking at their chart. And we realized that if we just had 7 shares, we were going to make $1,600 on that trade with just 7 shares. versus you can buy 1600 of a penny stock and it still doesn't move at all, or it moves one penny and you're like, oh, I only made $100. So really, you don't need a large quantity when you're picking companies that are healthy, because they will move on their own. Versus if you get these smaller companies that are not as reliable, you're more liable to lose money than to make money.
Yeah, and I guess the other thing is that some people are maybe not so comfortable with, short-term trading, as opposed to, as we said before, as opposed to, you're buying some stocks and kind of filing them away and just watching them over years. So what would you say to people to make them more comfortable, as you said, with maybe having some shorter-term goals?
I think with any new venture, it's okay to start small. I think one of the things that gives us a lot of fear is we think that I'm going to lose and I don't want to lose all my money. Well, start small. If you start with, okay, I'm going to start with $200 or $500, like I said before, or maybe I'll start with $1,000, you'll be okay. Like it's about learning a new skill set that you can have for life. Not so much about just, this is a one-time thing and I'm going to, like a slot machine, I'm gonna put it in and try to make all the money. No, this is a skill set that you have over time and you can use it for forever.
So tell me, what are some of the success stories you've had with your students as you endeavor to have 1,000 people making $1,000 a day?
You know, one that I just recently received and I was so excited about it. So actually, no, I'll tell you two. So one of them, I have a student who actually got coronavirus, and I know that I'm like, that's not a good thing, that's a bad thing. But he sent me an email and he talked about how much he loved my class and how he's been like still going through it. He was like, it's been slow, I'm taking it slowly but surely, but he's like, I love your class. He's like, and the thing he said which really got me, he said, some of the things you teach are so easy that I know I must be doing it wrong. because it's so simple. He's like, you're just a really great teacher. You make it really simple. And so to me, that just, for him to just say that I was a good teacher, but then also to know that during this time where he is going through a struggle, it's something that he can do in his pastime. Like while he's at home, while he's kind of sitting in the bed, recouping, he can learn this skill online, watch my curriculum online. So that was so sweet. And he's like, I'm getting this down. I'm making money in bed,
That's so fantastic. And I guess, as you said, the other thing there is obviously you have demystified the process very well, because if people are going, wow, this is so easy, I must be doing it wrong, means you have very, very successfully deconstructed it for people and made it, as I said, demystified.
Yes. And another success story is that one I was telling you about earlier, where it was the RN and she wanted to just get her time back. She recently actually was able to retire. She was able to quit her job and start trading full time. And she's actually made now $20,000 in a day. She just surpassed that goal. Yes. And she texts me all the time, but like one of the texts was, Terry, I just made more in a day than I would have made in a month as an RN. And you can just imagine, like right now with everything going on in the hospitals, she would have been an essential worker. She would have had to been out of the household and away from her kids. But now this gave her time back, and now she can decide how to have her time, right? So it like just the ability to get your time back and that little bit of freedom, I think that's the most important part of being an active trader.
Yeah, and that's what I was gonna say, is that concept of freedom and having the choice to like how you want to configure your life, and doing something like this, whether it's full-time, whether it's part-time, whether it's for some additional income, whether it's to replace income and do it full-time or whatever. I think these, the technology is there today. Obviously, the expertise from classes like yours is there today. I think it's wonderful to give people, that people have more choices than ever about how they want to configure their lives.
I totally agree. And I like your point where you said, even if it's just a small thing for extra income, because I have another student and his goal was just $10 a day because he wanted to get his own car that his wife didn't want him to get. So he said, if I just make $10 a day, I can pay for the car payment and not have to take it out of our family budget. And so he has, and actually now he's grown his account. Like, he started with 500, he grew it to 1,000, now it's at 10,000. But he's just like, Terry, you don't know. Just the fact that I can get this car and my wife can't say anything about it and I can still drive, like, he just wanted to pay for his car payment, you know? So even if it's just a little money to supplement your income, knowing how to generate that without having to go get a second job or without having to, you know, really start taking away from your family is another huge gain.
Yeah, no, that's a great story, actually. And again, it just shows, you know, it's different, you know, different motivations. But I think key to it all, and I'm sure as you discuss with your students, key to it all is figuring out what you want, right? Whether it's the $10 a day to buy a car, whether it's to give up your job and trade full time or whatever. I think it's obviously very important from the get-go to understand what your goals are.
Yes. And then breaking those goals down, because sometimes I think we get so afraid because it's so lofty of a goal. Mm-hmm. But when we start breaking it down into bite-sized pieces, we realize, hey, this is achievable. I can do this. If I just get like a little bit and, you know, one after another, hey, this is something that I can do.
Yeah, this is fantastic. Well, listen, Terry, this has been awesome. It's been it's such great stories you've shared and such great information you're putting out there. All of Terry's information is going to be in a contributor bio and links to her website. But before we go, Terry, please do tell people a little bit more about yourself and what you do.
Sure. So my name is Terry, and I used to be in education. I was an assistant principal of a elementary school, but I was able to replace my income by actively trading stocks. And I traveled all over the world, and now I teach others how to do that too. You can find a website about how I make $1,000 a day. I mean, not a website, a webinar, free webinar about how I make $1,000 a day at tradeandtravel.com.
Yeah, fantastic. So I would really, really encourage people to check it out. I think this is a, the pandemic and everything that's going on, it has been a great time of reflection. People have had the time to maybe stand back and take take another look at their lives, maybe look at their lives from a different angle. So something like this is maybe something that you would want to consider. So I would encourage people, you know, the opportunities are out there, and Terry obviously provides a fantastic one. So thank you very much for joining us today. I'll see you all for another expert interview really soon.
Thank you so much.